Hello children, today we are going to look at chapter 11, force and pressure. So what is the difference between a force and a pressure? A force is something where push or pull of an object with mass that causes it to change its velocity, that is, it changes its position. First of all, what is the difference between push or pull? Push means moving an object away from oneself. So you would have noticed this push or pull in most of the shops door handle. Yes, so if it has been mentioned as push, what will you do? You will move the object away from yourself, that is, you will push the door in the opposite side from yourself, that is called push. What about pull then? Moving an object towards oneself, that is, you will pull the door, you will drag the door towards yourself, that is called pull. So now you understood. So force is the push or pull of an object with mass where you are going to do that action. So which causes the object to change its position, which is velocity. Now we understood. And what is meant by pressure, which is defined as the physical force exerted on an object. So only when you apply some pressure on an object with full force, you will be able to move that object. That is called pressure. Now we understood the difference between force and pressure. So let us discuss a few questions related to this. How do objects move? Do you recall how we can decide whether an object is moving faster than the other? Then, what does the distance moved by an object in unit time indicate? So look at these two questions. Now related to this, we will look at an example. For example, you're about to roll a ball on the ground. You're rolling it with full force. So what will happen? Initially, the ball will go at a full speed on the ground. Later, it slows down and finally the ball will come to rest. So this is what will happen. Sometimes it may change its direction of motion. So the ball which you roll on the ground may go in a straight line, or it may change its direction here and there and move. So it depends on the force which you apply on the ball. Got it? Did you ever wonder what makes an object to slow down or go faster or change its direction? Obviously, the force and the pressure which you apply on the object. Now, let us recall some of our day-to-day experiences where we apply the force and pressure. See here, what do you do to make a football move? Then, what do you do to make a moving ball faster? Or how does a goalkeeper stop a ball? Then, how do fielders stop a ball hit by a batsman? Now, let us look at few pictures to answer these questions. Look at these three pictures. In the first picture, a goalkeeper is saving a goal. In the second picture, a hockey player flicking a ball with a hockey stick. And in the third picture, a fielder is stopping a ball. So how do you think these situations they will handle? In all these situations, the ball is either made to move faster or slower, or its direction of the motion is changed. For example, in the second picture, a hockey player is flicking the ball. So once he flicked the ball, the movement of the ball's position direction will change from one place to other place. That is, if it is moving in a straight line, what will happen? If he flicks the ball with a hockey stick, it may change its direction and it will move on the other side. So what happens here? The ball is made to move faster or it is made to move slower based upon the force which we apply on it. Similarly, in the third picture, what is happening? The fielder is stopping the ball. So even though the batsman hits the ball with full force, he is stopping the ball by applying some pressure over it and force over it. Now we understood. So force has been applied on a ball when it is kicked, pushed, thrown or flicked. Got it? Now force. I already told you force means a push or a pull. So look at this picture. Here one boy is pushing the door. So pushing, you know very well, moving an object away from oneself. That is, the boy here on the right hand side pushes the box towards the opposite side. So he is applying his full force and he is applying his full pressure to move the object towards the opposite side from himself. And what about pulling the side, left side? Here this boy is dragging the box towards himself, where he is using the option called pull. Now you understood the difference between push and pull. So actions like picking, opening, shutting, kicking, hitting, lifting, flicking, pushing, pulling are often used to describe certain tasks. So all these actions comes under the topic force, a push or a pull. And each of these actions usually result in some kind of change in the motion of an object. Understood? Now, here look at this table, identifying actions as push or pull. So here they have given a few descriptions of the situation. For example, in the first question, here they have given in the first option, moving a book placed on a table. In case a book is there on the table, you may move the book forward, or you may move the book towards yourself, or you may even lift a book. So all these actions are applicable on moving a book on placed on the table. So based on the situation, you are going to find out whether you are going to push the book, or whether you are going to pull it, or whether you are going to lift it. So you have to identify this and fill up the table. As well, the actions can be grouped as what? Whether push or pull. So push and pull both are applicable on moving a book placed on a table. Yes, so based on this first example which has been done for you, you have to do the remaining things and try to find out and guess the answers for the remaining things. Opening or shutting a door, what will you do? So when you try to open a door, you may push the door or you may pull the door by opening. So both the options are possible, but you cannot lift the door. Understood? Or you may even shut the door. So these situations are possible, these actions are possible, and push and pull is possible here. So you will give the answer as yes. So for this table, I have provided the answers in the next slide. See here, opening or shutting a door, pushing and pulling, lifting is not possible, and here lowering. So drawing a bucket of warm water from a well, you will lower the bucket, then you will lift the water, then you will pull the wheel on the well. Yes, and then football player taking a penalty kick, here he will lift the bat, he will kick it, he will lift the ball, he will kick the ball, he will hit the ball. So all these things are possible. So similar examples has been given in the next situation. Understood? And here, look at this situation here. In science, a push or a pull of an object is called a force. So force means you may apply a push or a pull pressure on the object, which is called as force. Only then you will be able to move the object, otherwise you can't. So we can say that the motion imparted to objects was due to the action of a force. Unless a force has been applied, you cannot move the object. So look at the simple example, push and pull. Here, the loudspeaker, using the loudspeaker, you will just convey the message. So what is happening? You are just pushing something. But this magnet, what it will do? It will attract all the objects, which is called pulling. So it will pull all the objects towards itself. Now you understood. So this is the difference between push and pull, which is called a force. So we will discuss about other topics in the next class. Thank you, children.